You know, there's a story in an ancient play about birds called The Birds. And it's a short story from before the world began. From a time when there was no earth, no land, only air and birds everywhere. Birds making huge patterns in the air. But the thing was, there was no place to land. Because there was no land. So they just circled around and around. Because this was before the world began. And the seasons were running and the light was expanding. And the sound was deafening. And songbirds were everywhere. Billions and billions and billions of birds. And one of these birds was a lark. And one day, her father died. And this was a really big problem, because what should they do with the body? And it was a big question, and it was a new question. And there was no place to put the body, because there was no earth. And it went on for 5 or 6 days, and they were all trying to think of what to do with the body. And finally, the lark had a solution. She decided to bury her father in the back of her own head. And this was the beginning of memory, because before this, no one could remember a thing. They were just constantly flying in circles, constantly flying in huge circles.
Thank you.
take you down. I'm gonna buy you out. I'm gonna own your country. I'm gonna force you out. 'Cause I'm a bad guy. So you can't walk. Put a hood on your head. I'm gonna make you talk. 'Cause I'm a bad guy. I'm a bad guy. It's a good time for bankers and winners and sailors. But their stories of jackpots and islands of pleasure. Doctor says, congratulations, it's a boy. Where do all the dream baby girls, those possible pearls, go? Loreen, Susan with the brown eyes, and a lovely Irene. And beautiful but difficult Betty. And tiny, tiny Juanita. They're so afraid to breathe, afraid to rise. We run and run in this transitory life. Tipped off balance, we fall like lead. We land on water in this transitory.
The person who's one of the 60% of the US population 1.3 weeks away, 0.3 paychecks away from homelessness. In other words, a person with problems. So an expert said, let's get to the root of them. Let's take control of the problem. Because if you take control of the problem, you can solve the problem. Now often this doesn't work at all because the situation is completely out of control. Because only an expert can deal with the problem at all. Because often the solution becomes the problem. Experts look for weapons, and sometimes they look everywhere for weapons, and sometimes when they don't find any weapons, sometimes the other experts say, if you haven't found any weapons, it doesn't mean there are no weapons. And other experts looking for weapons find things like cleaning fluids and refrigerator rods and small magnets, and they say, these may look like common objects to you, but in our opinion, they could be weapons. Or they could be used to make weapons. Or to ship weapons or store weapons. Because only an expert can see they might be weapons. And only an expert can deal with weapons. Because only an expert can deal with the problem. And only an expert can deal with the problem. And only an expert can deal with the problem. July and January, and there's no more snow, and huge waves are wiping out cities, and hurricanes are everywhere, and everyone knows it's a problem. But if some of the experts say it's no problem, and other experts claim it's no problem, or explain why it's no problem, then it's simply not a problem. But when an expert says it's a problem, and makes a movie about the problem, and wins an Oscar about the problem, and gets a Nobel Prize about the problem, then all the other experts have to agree it is most likely a problem. Because only an expert can deal with the problem, and only an expert can deal with the problem, and only even though a country can invade another country and flatten it and ruin it and create havoc and civil war in that other country, if the experts say it's not a problem, and everyone agrees they're experts and good at seeing problems, then invading those countries is simply not a problem. And if the country tortures people and holds citizens without cause or trial and sets up military tribunals, this is also not a problem. Unless there's an expert who says, this is the beginning of a problem. Because so only an expert can deal with the problem, and only an expert can deal with the problem, and only an expert can deal with the problem. Only an expert can deal with the problem, and only an expert can deal with the problem, and only an expert can deal with the problem. 'Cause only an expert can see there's a problem, and see the problems have the problem, and only an expert can deal with the problem. Only an expert can deal with the problem.
Your silence will be considered him, sir. This world, which, like Kierkegaard said, can only be as good when lived backwards, which would entail an incredible amount of planning and confusion. Then there are those big questions always at the back of your mind, like, are those two people over there actually my real parents? Should I get a second Prius? And you could be silent in four languages. Your silence will be considered your consent. You know, I see myself dressed in old plaid. My eyes gleaming in black like nail heads popping out of the wood, waiting for the hammer. The reason I really love the stars is that we cannot hurt them. We can't burn them, we can't hurt them, we can't make them overflow. We can't flood them or blow them up or turn them out. But we are reaching for them. We are reaching for them. Oh, but those were the days before the audience. And what the audience wanted. And what the audience said it wanted. And the truth itself was so untransferable. The pitfalls, the pratfalls, the pit bulls, the bullfights, the long nights, the falls from the heights. And my face is still laughing long, long. Stuck in this expression, some kind of new pause mode, impossible to cancel. And guided by convictions, not my own. I go forward. And oh, it's so quiet here. And it's oh, so clever. So full of mumbo and bling. You know, most animals, when they die, look for a place to hide. Small birds just fall to the sidewalk as if this was a natural stage of life. As if it was part of the plan to lay there near the speeding traffic. Garbage trucks about to back over them. Hey, you know that scene in the movie? A man comes running into the saloon and he's out of breath and he skids to a halt and he's looking around kind of wildly and he says, "There's trouble out at the mine! There's trouble out at the mine!" And every single person in the bar stops whatever they're doing. People drinking stop with a glass halfway to their mouths. The card players stop in the middle of the deal. The bartender comes out from behind the bar. And they all go running out through the swinging door. Citizens, patriots, there's trouble out of the mine. Drop what you're doing. There's trouble. There's trouble out of the mine.
In my heart, boys, heart, boys. then vanish. Unstoppable time. All the things we left behind. Empty your mind. Let the rest of the world go by. And when the tears fall from both my eyes, they fall from my right eye. Because I love you, and they fall from my left eye, 'cause I cannot bear you. Rocks and stones, broken bones. Everything eventually comes crawling home. Comes crawling. Comes crawling. They start walking around the city in their huge much underwear. And they're massive. And they get down from the billboards, yes. And they walk right down the big avenues. And everyone has to get out of their way. And the only ones exactly the right size, the right scale, for the city. The only ones big enough to fit in anywhere, and they're ready for anything, and they say, who cares? Who cares?
Thank you. See that photograph? On the front page of the Times a few weeks ago. It's a picture of a girl hugging her dad. And she's looking up at him and crying. And it looked like some kind of recruitment center. All these soldiers milling around. And then I saw the caption. And it was the girl who did.
Kids in uniforms. And all those Palestinian kids who are the suicide bombers. You know, it's like a kid's war. It's like a kid's crusade or something. And and all the armies just keep dropping their restrictions. So just about anyone can join. If you've got a few convictions, no problem. Come on in. Business is good. The market keeps rising. The big machines control the sea and the air. Those big machines, they gotta go somewhere. So we keep calling them up.
Call them, call them, call them. No matter what we
things from the Middle Ages, beheadings and hangings, and people in cages, and suddenly they're everywhere, and suddenly they're all right. Welcome to the American. Long lost roots.
fall is shattered to the ground,
like something left in the lost and found. For its fall, they make no sense, no sense at all. Who these
Just please don't tell me about any more new ideas or introduce me to any more new people or new products or new colors, because they're just going to remind me of the originals. They're just going to be crummy copies. Then again, the Dalai Lama said that artificial plants are okay since they remind you of the real ones. The state of things. The things that keep disappearing. Pictures of things and things with pictures in them and unknown. And then there's the audience, composed mostly of my relatives, and not particularly friendly ones. The rest must have just slipped out for a smoke. But I live in an old warehouse down by the river, and as a self-employed and self-motivated spy, I've been filing these reports for years now. And the only problem is that recently, I've been running out of invisible ink. And I make speeches all the time to myself. But they are full of despair. This black Irish despair. You probably know exactly what I'm talking about. You know, in hotels, it's funny how immediately possessive you can get about what's called my room. And how hard they try to convince you that it hasn't been vacated just moments before your arrival. The pillow's still hot. The air still vibrating with the sounds and smells, the voices, the aftershaves of the last guest. Ah, yes. He emerges into a world filled with crud. New plastics. New elastics. Oh, it's so quiet here. And it's oh, so glamorous. So full of bombo. Walking around France, the haystacks in the background, the cattle lowing, and the lanes full of flowers. And at night, robbers and sex in the air everywhere, and perfumes to hide the reeking piles of offal. And so, it was only a picture book, really. The sky. The land. The sky. Thank you. fellow musicians. Eyvind, Kang, and Viola.
Conversation. The lost eye. Conversation.
Letters to New Yorkers lately about what to do in the event of an evacuation. And he describes about 50 days you'll need to have around in order to be prepared for a number of potential threats. And these items include a whistle, personal hygiene products, a fire extinguisher, and also a go bag, which is kind of a suitcase on wheels, containing your car keys, your ID, a first aid kit, and he suggests approximately $50 in cash. Now, speaking of readiness, the NRA has been campaigning in Texas to convince women to carry handguns in their purses so they'd feel more secure. Now, the late governor of Texas, Ann Richards, said, "Don't I'm no sexist, but there's not a single woman in Texas who could find a gun in her handbag."